make the flywheel, I used 3/4 inch plywood, drilled the center hole, sanded it round on the circle sanding jig on the disc sander, drilled the holes to cut out these web sections. After sanding the inside of the spoke areas to smooth everything on the spindle sander, I rounded over the edges for the spoke cutouts on the outside of the wheel on both sides. I put a fold flat safety handle. When this thing's spinning around, there's no reason for this to be sticking out where it can hit somebody. That flips up, and you can crank the Argon, you pull that up, you can lay it down. The attachment bolt appeared to be 1/4-28, but it's actually 6 millimeter, and this indexing or locking pin was 1/4 inch from center, and it was almost 1/8, so I drilled that out for 1/8. I took a 1-inch fender washer, drilled a hole through it, and put a piece of 1/8 inch piano wire. It doesn't quite go all the way through the wood. So then this handle sits on top of that. With the fender washer on this side, I took a Farnester bit, just cut a little cavity so that would sit flush, and then a 1-inch long 6 millimeter bolt worked out just perfect. We can see this is quite out of balance, the handle on the cranking wheel, and it really won't make much difference when we're hand cranking it, but when we're driving it with the motor drive, I think it'll be a noticeable vibration. So this will be turning 60-70 RPM. So now we're going to add a couple of lead weights. It seems to turn a lot smoother. Stop there. That's not too bad. So now I know I need approximately this much lead positioned out here away from the handle. So I'll take the handle off. I'm going to drill a couple of pockets in here with a Farnester bit. We'll heat this lead up and cast it in there. We'll heat this lead up and cast it in there. Plus just a little more lead to compensate for the fact that we're taking some wood out of here. And we'll do a trial balance. And when we get it pretty good, then I'll fill that in with some wood putty or sawdust and glue. And that'll be on the back side of the wheel. You won't be able to see it anyway. This was 1¼-inch hole drilled with a Farnester bit. It's about 1/2 inch deep. The center points of that bit were getting very close to the surface, so I filled that with a little wood putty. The wood here is about 1/4 inch thick. So hopefully, when we put that hot lead in there, it won't burn the outside face. I've put the lead in this stainless steel pot. One thing about stainless steel, lead won't stick to it. So we'll heat that up and cast it in there, let it cool, and then do the other one. I had taken the handle off so this would lay flat while I cast the lead. Then when it cooled off, these lead coupons were falling out because they had shrunk up a little bit. I've glued those back in, put the handle on, give this a test spin. Looks like it's just a little bit heavy on this side. By the time I get this filled in with wood putty, and that has dried, it should be pretty close. And I think it's certainly going to be close enough for the 60-70 RPM target speed I have for the Argon. I mixed up some oak sawdust with tight bond glue, and generally, by the time this dries, it'll turn kind of black. That seems to be a reaction between the tight bond and oak sawdust. But once that's dry, this will be a little bit depressed. I'll fill that in with some wood putty that's about that color and then sand it off flush. I'm going to need another hand wheel for the second organ. So I've made one that has three spokes. And I have one that has one spoke. Haven't decided which one I'm going to use yet, but in any case, they will also need to be balanced. The handle will go on here like this, or it'll go on this one like that. And this ring, as this thing's spinning around, that's really just to keep somebody from getting hit by this thing when it's going around, when it's being driven by the motor. To make these, I'm using Mathias's gear template generator program. I just cut off the teeth of the gear. And I reshaped the inside of the cutouts a little bit. I use that program for a lot of stuff. It's very handy.